Good afternoon, all the industry colleagues. I am Sri Prakash from AMP Solar, taking care for the distributed generation business for AMP in India. So just to bring to the perspective to the panel discussion, since it's the second discussion after lunch, we'll try to make it as lively as possible, and maybe we'll be touching one of the most relevant topics which are actually prevailing in the industry. So if you see the overall rooftop market growth in India for any, means it's more of a technology product, for any technology product to actually establish itself, it goes through a three-phase. First is a proof of concept, which in the initial stage, it needs to prove to the people and the user that the technology is successful. And there is a lot of demonstration which goes upon on the project, on the product. Once the technology is established, then the second phase is the market transformation phase, where the people actually starts adopting the technology. And with the help of the regulators, which is which in India mainly MNRE and SECI, they try to spread to the maximum people through government support, through various schemes. And the third stage, once it reaches the scale and the mass, then the third and the last stage is the self-replication stage, where actually people start using the product by itself. The intervention of regulator becomes minimum, and more people just try to take it as a normal commodity product. So the overall solar business, specifically rooftop, is going through that phase. And mainly as of now, if you see, the Indian market is in the stage two, which is mainly a market transformation stage, where the support from government is there, but now the transition is happening from market transformation to the self-replication stage, where we can see through the subsidy portion has been reduced. Now it is limited only to residential and the industrial, residential and the institutional customers. Initially, the percentage of subsidy was also reduced. If you see the overall market also, earlier it was more of a capex market. Almost 80-85% of the installation was on capex. Now the transition is happening from capex to opex. Opex is taking charge for most of the installations happening across India. And similarly, when we are moving to a more self-replicating phase, we are facing various challenges also. So means to mention few, now that we are moving from an capex to opex market, we require more of a funding. And in the present scenario, if you see, for government projects, banks are ready to fund, but for private projects, there are a lot of issues. Even the we have heard about a lot of foreign banks or institutions giving money to Indian banks to lend to rooftop sector, but still it is not happening as far as the private customers are concerned. We heard about a 500 million loan given to SBI by World Bank, but the actual dissemination to private people is not happening. It's mainly concentrating mainly on the government rooftop projects. Secondly, was the Asian Development Bank, which gave something to Punjab National Bank. Finally, it has not been given to developer, it has been actually given to the end consumer. So there are challenges which we are facing. Second thing is the implication of GST, which has come up. So that again, there is we have already had a good session with PwC, but still there is lot to be cleared as far how it's going to be implemented, and mainly in case of OPEX, where the electricity has been put out of GST. So for a developer, the entire GST is coming as a cost, and there is no credit which a developer can actually get. He has to actually rope in an EPC player to get its cost reduced. I don't know whether it will be actually possible. So the panel will be discussing mainly on the challenges which we are facing. And to start the discussion, since Mr. Satya, who is from Godrej and Boyce, they are into rooftop segment from last 5 years or so, and they have been doing EPC for rooftop businesses across India. Just like to understand what are the key trends, opportunities and challenges that they are actually facing in replicating rooftop in a big manner. So Satya.
Yeah, thank you. To start with the rooftop, the ground mounted section is almost in the fragmented stage. If when you compare with the rooftop business, and the, I mean the corporates or the like who are the bigger roofs available in the India, they compare the rooftop business with the ground mounted business. They see every day the tariffs are coming down and they see a lot of changes happening in the ground mounted segment, and they compare that with the rooftop business, which is a different segment comparing with the ground mounted. So, and apart from that, there are a lot of education also need to be done to the corporates and other like the end users who wanted to set up a rooftop segment. Still, I mean, some people believe that there is a subsidy available for the industries and other other sectors, which is like these are the most important challenge when you approach a client and you are pitching for your project, and he always tell there is a subsidy because of the government is giving lot many advertisements and many things, but they are not aware that, you know, the subsidy is available only for the domestic clients and non-profit organizations. So a lot of education need to be done to for the corporates and other industrial consumers. And apart from that, I mean, there are other issues also, like quality issues and the price comparison issues in the industry segment, not like a domestic segment. There are a lot many players, but in the industry segment, only the comparison happens with the price to price. What is the price you are offering? There are the other companies offering a different prices, and the comparison goes on, but the industry who wants to install, they are not fully aware of the what the technology and what are the options provided by each, and the apple to apple comparison is not possible in the, with the like uneducated client. So there are a lot of challenges we are facing to you know, to sell a product, I mean to sell a rooftop product to particular clients. And apart from that, rooftop integration in we are facing challenges to get the you know, the structure manufacturers. At some places there are, you know, superstructures and other structures. There are only few companies who does the very you know, quality work to get those kind of you know, products also. So it is still the industry need to be more organized in terms of structure manufacturers. And in the GST point of view, actually only from the last 2 weeks we are clear that solar power generating system falls under 5% category. Earlier it was we are unclear, and we were not able to book the orders also because of the it was not clear. Everything is different, like modules at 5% and inverters are at 5%, and there are like many other components which fall under 18%. So only the right now, like from past 2 weeks, it is now clear the solar power generating system comes under 5%, and now I mean we are able to, you know, clear the taxing part. And apart from that, I mean the subsidy need to be clearly taken off, or then it has to be only for the government institutions they should provide, because most of the consumers are from industry segment, and people get confused with the subsidy availability, and the people think that everybody is available for the take the subsidy. So these are the my views.
Yeah, Satya, well said. I think most of us will agree, since now that the overall solar business in India has picked up. So as per the details available, more than 1,000 channel partners are already registered with MNRE. And in case, if India actually wants to implement a 40,000 megawatt of rooftop across by 2022, for an EPC company also it becomes very important that they need not have to do EPC all by themselves. They can actually sublet lot of the activities, because there are number of players who are doing the overall BOS activities. There are number of players who are specializing only in structure installations, module installations. Maybe they can be of a great help if you actually want to put rooftop capacities across geography. Because one of the most important thing for rooftop is there can be a lot of order booking. Maybe a company can book an order of 30-40 megawatt, but to actually execute it in a 6 months time, it's really difficult until unless they have partners all across the geography. So maybe to actually get rid of the challenges, it is also important for companies to have a lot of partnership with the local players who are active in specific geographies, which can actually help in fast implementation of rooftop projects, and also they can also ensure the quality of the projects. The second most important thing is when we talk about 1 lakh megawatt of solar to be installed across India, the majority of it will come from the utility scale. And utility scale, there are a lot of developers, and there are also key EPC players who are actually feeling the heat when the prices of, when the tariff is coming so down. So we'd like to have a view of Dheeraj Malani, who is actually head of business development from Mahindra Sustain, one of the key EPC and also the developer company, to have their have his perspective on what is the challenges that they are actually facing when the tariff is coming so low, and what the developer is expecting from a EPC company. He'll be in a better position to tell, because he is sitting on both sides of the table. He is also a developer and also an EPC player. So Dheeraj, what's your view?
Thanks, Shiri. So I would like to focus first on the challenges what an EPC player is facing when they are going to execute such bigger scale, utility scale projects. Because in the past, last 3 years, we started with a industry of 5 megawatt or 10 megawatt, 20 megawatt scale projects. And then with a change in government and the change in targets from 20 gigawatt to 100 gigawatt, the size of the project suddenly increased from 5, 10 megawatt, 20 megawatt to a 50, 100 or a 500 megawatt scale projects. But whether the entire value chain has also grown in the same fashion which it can support, that is a question here. And with the current tariffs, I do agree that these tariffs are based on some number calculations on the financing front, some aggressive numbers have been taken, and some cash flow management is there. But still, there is a pressure over the EPC on the BOS portion, that how much optimization it can be possible. So straight away, there is a cost pressure over the EPC companies, and there are solutions for it also. Every time, it cannot be a cost cutting which you have to do in the entire plant. You can do some kind of optimizations. Like earlier, if you were using an RCC kind of rooms for your power plants, now you can shift yourself to a prefabricated or a containerized solutions, which can give a plug and play kind of system to you. Like we have seen in the previous presentation, that 1500 volt module system is coming up. So we have to shift the entire system from a 1000 volt system to a 1500 volt system. Earlier, we were in the phase of smaller size inverters, where we were making a block of 3 megawatt or a 4 megawatt size. Now with the revised inverter capacities, enhanced inverter capacities, we can make a bigger inverter block size of 6.8 megawatt or at 8 or 10 megawatt size. So all these things, all these improvements, all these optimizations will lead to a cost optimization. And that is how we think that maybe the current tariffs or the upcoming tariffs can be met. The second challenge will be on the delivery front, whether the EPC players or the self EPC companies also, can they be able to deliver the projects in time? Because most of the time, these projects are of a duration of 12 months or a 15 months or an 18 months duration, out of which 7 to 8 months easily go with your land acquisition process, with your registration process, with your financing process. So hardly what is left for a construction period is 4 or at max a 5 months period, with an evacuation at a very higher voltage. Earlier, it was a 33 kV system, which doesn't require a switchyard or a power transformer. Now every power plant has to have only 66 kV, 132 kV or a 220 kV systems, and where a power transformer is a major long lead items. So we have to manage that also. Third is the quality, which has to be maintained, because if we cut the corners and we do a cost cutting, then quality will hamper, and that will not deliver the required result for the next 25 years. Maybe Arun can better tell you about the quality thing. Another challenge is handling the large size projects, because till now the EPCs have not faced, every EPC player has not faced such kind of challenges. We have faced in the SoftBank project recently, which we have commissioned 250 megawatt at a single location. The challenges with respect to a large size projects is entirely different. Even a demonetization of the money has also played a critical role there, because the labor were not available for the work at that point of time. So you have to innovate ideas how to have the labor there and to complete the project in time, because the penalties are heavy and huge. And then the supply chain problem also. The entire supply chain you have to manage in such a way that neither on the cash flow there is a problem, and neither the project will suffer any kind of shortages. The last is the skill sets, which is lacking there because enough skilled labor is not available, and using labors just like whatever is available at the regional levels or at the village levels will not suffice the purpose. So we have to have such kind of institutions which can enhance the knowledge of all those workers, giving them a training of 2 to 3 months over how the solar projects behaves, and to have that kind of workmanship quality inside the solar projects, then only the quality will be maintained, the required skill sets will be there. So all these problems are there, and certainly there are solutions also associated with it, because if the target is 100 gigawatt and right now we are sitting at 13 gigawatt, in a year of 3 or 4 years, if we have to manage that kind of levels, then all have to gear up at a very larger scale. Thank you.
Thank you, Dheeraj. Seeing the present scenario, the ground mounted bidding is becoming a big boys game. So anyhow, the project size now, the average project size is more than 100 megawatts, so EPC will have a lot many challenges in the coming future, because the average project size now that it has increased to 100 megawatts, so they have to actually gear up and execute the big projects. So that's definitely the ask of the day. If at all we need to achieve a target of 60,000 megawatt in grid connected. So now, Mr. Arun Kumar, we have a very stringent task to ensure that we need to deliver the project at the cheapest cost, and also to ensure it runs for 25 years. So what are your views whether at this price level we are actually able to achieve the quality which will enable the project to run for 25 years?
Before we touch upon the subject, many a times when we are going for either rooftop or for utility scale projects, and even if you look at the MNRE guidelines, quality is always coming at the last page. And after that, what you do is, before you realize something has gone wrong, you can never come back. So what is the biggest risk in either when you take a rooftop or if you take a utility scale of power plants? There is what is called as risk mitigation measures, which should happen right from the ground level. Now, what is happening in case of, let me give an example. When you talk about rooftop, many felt rooftop is nothing great. Okay, you just go and put a panel on the rooftop and you generate electricity. They are right in all respect, 100% they are right. But what are the challenges in a rooftop? Very, 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 I'll just like to share one incident which happened. And you can imagine, how well it went through. There's a bank which ordered for a 2 kilowatt rooftop. And the gentleman who got the order walks with the panel the next day, and he says, sir, where do you put the panel? He said, go right on the top. Where else can you fit the panel? He says, where's the staircase? They don't know where to go. Where's the staircase to go up now? Then they said, okay, do one thing. Go to the next building, there's a staircase, and jump onto this building. Fine, all said and done, you have no other choice, you go and do it. Then they saw, when they went to that building, they saw there's a building on the west, there's a building on the east, huge building. And how much of sunshine is going to get on this building now? Hardly 1 hour, 2 hours. And what is the point in putting a solar? So you see, this is what is happening in our country today. There is no pre-feasibility study done. Okay, let me take an example of a recent tender from the government side. They said all government buildings should be solarized. Right? Let's look at some of the government buildings. Okay, you'll find a lot of trees. lot of space they got. Now, if you want to do a solar, I mean, you want to put up a rooftop solar on these buildings, you need to do a pre-feasibility study first. Whether it's possible to put a solar panels on the rooftop, or what should we do? Should we say no to this government buildings? You know, not possible. Just say not possible. Otherwise, what's the point in putting a solar rooftop when you can't generate? We have seen. See, I mean, all of you should be very much worried about, because the subsidies which we have been talking about all through this morning session is whose money? It's your money, right? The government may be giving subsidy of 30%, 40% as they talk about, but whose money is this? It's your money, right? So we're all stakeholders. We have to start asking the government, okay, fine, this is my money and you can't waste it now. So let's look at some of these things, you know, like what has been discussed about the net metering. When they said, okay, let's have the rooftop, the net metering was taking a backstage. A lot of issues happened. Today, I'm saddened to see that Mr. Abhilak Singh of IREDA said that 20 gigawatts has been taken out from rooftop. And 20 gigawatt has gone to solar parks now. So the greatest generation which you can do from solar is from distributed generation. It's utility, okay, fine. But this has gone off now. Why? Because of all these things. No pre-feasibility study done earlier. A lot of issues regarding net metering. And the same thing happened in one of the states, I don't want to name them. They said that they floated a tender for about for the rooftops of residential rooftop. They received 120 applications. Then I asked them, simple thing, there are about 20 houses which want to generate. Do you have, the transformer has got the capability of taking this? No one has done a study of this. Then they reverted back, they said, okay, fine, let's do this study and come back. So what's happening is people are not trying to realize there are a lot of complication involved. It is not that simple to go ahead with the rooftop. Okay, that's the reason why today you see the not much of rooftops have not come up in India, because the basic thing has not been done. Then if you talk about the utility scale, in fact, I was talking to MNRE for quite some time on standards, risk mitigation measures to be implicated and brought into the tenders. All tenders should carry some sort of a testing. The standard should be in place. If you look at the MNRE guideline, it says component has to be certified as per IEC standard or IS standard. Fine, all said done. Now when it comes to the power plant, what are the standard you follow for safety and quality? Okay, I mean, we have Mahindra Susten here. Okay, they are what, third spot in EPC or fourth when compared to Sterling? Sterling is one.
We are second.
So, you know, a lot of things goes into quality and safety of power plants. So I've been also telling Mahindra Susten, you voluntarily follow. Don't wait till the government comes and says, hey, you guys, you have to build a power plant like this. You go ahead voluntarily. There is a standard already available globally. Follow the standards. There is a standard which is known as IEC 62446, which talks about how you have to build a power plant, wherein documentation, right from documentation to final inspection and testing, is being done. Now today I am happy to tell you that if you go back, just go back to solar rooftop MNRE, you'll find a guideline which is being given how a solar rooftop has to be built. The guideline is so good, it also talks about the standard. So something good has happened in the country town. Okay, fine now. So all rooftops which are going to come up have to be necessarily tested as per the standard. So for what? For 25 years life cycle of its, you know. Otherwise what happens is each and everyone goes, he builds his power plant as he wants. Finally, after 10 years, you don't see any power plants. I'll tell you an incident where JNSSM phase 1, the number of power plants which was done, hardly you see some which is really generating to its fullest capacity. So I think maybe this is one of a very important point that has been missed out with respect to rooftop and utility scale. Maybe we'll have to see down the line how this is also applicable for utility when it comes as something mandatory. Unless government says it is mandatory,
I mean, nothing happens and we continue going ahead, and after 25 years, we'll see no, I mean, less than about 15 to 20% of the solar plant functioning, rest are all dead. Thank you.
Arun Kumarji, very well said, but this is the reason, if at all people are, they have participated in the SECI 1000 megawatt rooftop tender, if they are actually following this tender, it started with 1000 megawatt, and after that, with lot of questions being raised in the pre-bid meeting about the capacity which they have mentioned state-wise, building-wise, a revised survey was done, and it was actually reduced to 500 megawatt. So maybe the government is following what we are trying to say, maybe, but they are taking a taking some more time to actually do it. And regarding when you're talking about the MNRE specifications, mainly as of now it is restricted mainly for the projects where the government subsidy is involved. I think it should be applicable for all the rooftop installation with or without subsidy, so that, because we are seeing lot of bloodbath when it comes to the project being offered to private customers, because there is no benchmark. The pricing are going haywire, and I don't know whether the project will actually be able to sustain 25 years.